First of all, I generally spend about an hour with the patient on the day of the procedure, first explaining the typical consent form type information, what they are to expect. I then explain what the step by step procedure is going to be. Even though I've already explained it during the consultation, I go through it once more. I want the patient to understand how hair transplantation with today's technique is truly a team approach, what the responsibilities and skills of each individual in that team are, so that and explain the experience of that particular team member so that they are totally comfortable with everything that's going to take place during that procedure. After that, I spend quite a bit of time, sometimes up to 45 minutes, actually marking or designing artistically the area that I'm going to work. I don't just draw straight lines. I actually mark, in many cases, the exact position of where every single opening that I'm going to make for each transplant along the hairline area is going to be. I find that that way I can visualize it before I begin the procedure, and I immediately feel more comfortable that I can project forward to what the result is going to be, rather than to freehand that or leave it to chance when I'm making an opening for a graft during the procedure. Then obviously the procedure takes place in a way in which it is least traumatic or least painful to the patient. Perhaps from having been a patient myself, I've devised unique techniques using vibration technology to try to make the local anesthesia not felt as much. I am quite bothered if a patient is uncomfortable. So besides very meticulous scientific technique to make sure that the highest number of grafts are going to grow, artistic sense to make sure that the overall design is going to be natural, and then lastly, to make the experience a good one for the individual.